Hello from Chem Help ASAP. In this playlist, let's highlight the complementary reactivity of some different carbonyl compounds. If you've been watching these videos on this channel in a typical order, then you have seen a lot of different reactions of carbonyl compounds. Let's put the alpha-halogenated ketones into the broader context of this carbonyl chemistry. On the top line, we have a ketone reacting with a base. We know what happens. We're going to form an enolate. Enolates are strong nucleophiles. We can then treat the enolate with a weak electrophile. Things like alkyl halides or other carbonyl compounds to make new molecules. Enolates are incredibly flexible intermediates. On the bottom line, we have a ketone reacting with NCS and chlorosicinamide in acid. This reaction goes through an enol and forms an alpha-chloroketone. In contrast to the nucleophilic enolate, alpha-chloroketones are weak electrophiles. The haloketones react with a range of strong SN2 nucleophiles. These SN2 reactions are actually especially favorable because of something called the phenacyl effect, which we've seen in a different video. So on this slide, we see an interesting contrast in reactivity. We can start with a ketone. Through enolate chemistry on top, the alpha carbon becomes a nucleophile and can react with electrophiles. Through enol chemistry and making haloketones, the alpha carbon becomes an electrophile and can react with nucleophiles. This slide highlights the incredible flexibility of carbonyl chemistry, and this is a reason why so much of organic chemistry is dominated by carbonyl-based reactions.